وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى, in this session I want to take the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where he says, الله خالق كل شيء وهو على كل شيء وكيل له مقاليد السماوات والأرض والذين كفروا بآيات الله أولئك هم الخاسرون قل أفغير الله تأمروني أعبد أيها الجاهلون قل أفغير الله تأمروني أعبد أيها الجاهلون ولقد أوحي إليك وإلى الذين من قبلك لئن أشركت ليحبطن عملك ولتكونن من الخاسرين بل الله فاعبد وكن من الشاكرين وما قدر الله حق قدري والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. Inshallah ta'ala, these are the verses I want to, bi'inni Allah al-Kareem, cover with you all. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah is the creator of everything. Khaliqul ashiya'a kullaha. Everything, he's the creator of it. Wa rabbuha wa malikuha, he's his lord. He owns it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's his king, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal mutasarrifu fiha, he's the one who controls it the way he wants it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فهو وحده الخالق بذاته وصفاته وما سواه كله مخلوق. Everything other than him is created. سبحانه وتعالى. He is the creator. سبحانه وتعالى. الله تبارك وتعالى, he says, وهو على كل شيء وكيل. After that, وهو, Allah is, على كل شيء, everything, وكيل. وكيل means حفيظ, رقيب, مطلع, ومدبر. He's the one who safeguards. He's the one who observes and takes care of. He's the one who looks over, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and controls because of his knowledge of everything and his ability over everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his wisdom. Allah then says, لَهُ مَقَالِيدُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يعني له, لعني له وحده. For him alone is مَقَالِيدُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. مَقَالِيدُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ means what? مَفَاتِيح, the keys, the knowledge, the treasures, the controlling, the azimah al-umur, يعني the riding beast. There's a rope that you use, the rein that you ride your riding beast. That is in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything in this world, meaning, is in His hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He controls it. بإذن الله الكريم. As Allah mentioned in Surah Fatir, ما يفتح الله للناس من رحمة فلا ممسك لها وما يمسك فلا مرسل له من بعده وهو العزيز الحكيم. If Allah chooses to give somebody something, there's no one who can stop it. And if He chooses to withhold something from someone, there is no one who can go and give it to that person. وهو, Allah is العزيز, يعني الغالب في أمره, overpowers and overcomes everything, سبحانه وتعالى. الحكيم ذو حكمة واسعة, the one who has vast wisdom. Allah then says, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ, those who disbelieve in Allah's آيات, يعني الآيات الشرعية والآيات الكونية. They disbelieve in Allah تبارك وتعالى's universal signs, the stars and the sun. They look at all of that and they don't believe in Allah. They also disbelieve in the legislative, you know, signs of Allah تبارك وتعالى, the Kitab, the Quran, and the Sunnah. They disbelieve in all of that. Allah says, أولئك هم الخاسرون. This jumla is مؤكدة, it's emphasis, and because it's a jumla ismiya, right? Okay. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ ذَوْزِ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. So this jumla is a mu'akkida, it's an emphasis, بِكَوْنِهَا إِسْمِيَةً, because it's a jumla ismiya, right? مُعَرَّفَةٌ الطَّرَفَيْنِ وَبِضَمِيرِ الْفَصْلِ, which is hum, that's there, are you there, brothers and sisters? Which also benefits grammatically, tawkid. And it's also exclusivity, al-hasr, which is humul khasiruna haqqan ay la ghayru, no one else. They are the true losers here. Alladhina balagu ghayat al-khusran, they reach the highest level of khusran. Who are they? Yani walladhina kafaru bi ayati Allah, the one who disbelieve in Allah's signs, whether it be the universal or the legislative, doesn't matter. These people are humul khasiruna, yani humul khasiruna haqqan, they are the khasiruna haqqan la ghayru, no one else. الَّذِينَ بَلَغُوا غَايَةَ الْخُسْرَانِ, they reached the pinnacle, the highest level of khusran. Ah. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, قُلْ say to the Muhammad, أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَأْمُرُونِّي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, قُلْ say to the Muhammad, أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ, besides Allah, تَأْمُرُونِّي. تَأْمُرُونِّي, there's different qira'at. There's the qira'at of Nafi' and Abu Ja'far, which is بِالتَّخْفِيفِ النون. So he reads it as تأمروني. That's how he recites it. Ibn Amir, he recites it with بنونين خفيفتين, two noons which are خفيف. The first one is a fatha on it, and the second one is مكسورة. Okay, that's how he recites it. Whereas the other remaining قراء, they recite it with a يعني one noon which is مشددة, which has a كسر in it, which is what I read, which is تأمروني أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ. The istifham here, قُلْ أَفْهَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ, the alif there is alif al-istifham. The istifham here is lil-inkar, which I mentioned quite a lot of times in through the series, which is قُلْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ صلى الله عليه وسلم, O Muhammad, say to them, لِهَؤُلَاءِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, say to these mushrikeen, الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَكَ إِلَىٰ عِبَادَةِ آلِهَتِهِمْ, who are calling you to worship their Lord, say to them, قُلْ أَفْهَ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَأْمُرُونَ ني أعبد, يعني أتأمروني, are you commanding me, أعبد غير الله, to worship other than Allah, أيها الجاهلون, oh you ignorant ones, يعني أيها الجاهلون here means يا أيها الجاهلون, جاهلون of what, بعظمة الله تعالى وما يجب له, you are ignorant about Allah's يعني ultimate strength and ability, you are ignorant of what Allah's rights are سبحانه وتعالى وما له من الكمال والجلال واستحقاقي وحده العبادة دون ما سواه. He's the only one who deserves to be worshipped. You're really ignorant about all of that. ولذلك ابن كثير mentions in his tafsir that Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنه, عنهما, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, he mentioned أن المشركين بجهلهم دعوا رسول الله. The mushrikeen, due to their ignorance, they called the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام إلى عبادة آلهتهم, to worship their idols. وَيَعْبُدُونَ مَعَهُ آلِهَتَهُ, and they said to him, we worship your Lord with you, you worship our one with us. And that's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala sent this down to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to them, قُلْ أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَأْمُرُونِي أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَئِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Allah says, وَلَقَدْ, يعني يا محمد, we have sent to you, وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ أي مِنَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَالرُّسُلِ, the messengers and the prophets that were sent before you, we sent to them. لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ, the lamb here is مَوْطِئَةٍ لِلْقَسَمِ, it means أي والله لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ, Allah is swearing subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you, Allah is swearing, and we would have believed him subhanahu wa ta'ala without having him swear subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says والله لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ, and we say, brothers, وَحَاشَهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ, والله the prophet is far from doing shirk عليه الصلاة والسلام, shirk he won't do it عليه الصلاة والسلام. He won it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Lakin, brothers and sisters, here you have to understand the qa'idah that the scholars mentioned, وَالشَّرْطُ لَا يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ وُقُوعِ الْمَشْرُوطِ, just the condition doesn't mean the mashrut is going to happen. It doesn't mean it's always going to happen. That's not always the case. But here it means, يعني, عَلَىٰ إِمْكَانِهِ, if it did happen, lakin. Like Allah mentioned in Surah, for example, Yunus, where Allah says, فَإِنْ كُنْتَ فِي شَكٍ مِمَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ, if you are Muhammad, you're in state of doubt in what we have sent to you. Again, this is not something that the Prophet ﷺ would ever have عليه الصلاة والسلام. But here it's us that's being spoken to. لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ If Allah is saying this to the Prophet, you're going to be like, what about us? That's what the idea here is. لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ The lam here is what وَاقَعَتُ فِي جَوَابِ الْقَسَمِ It's the response of the wallahi that Allah swore. Wallahi لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ Wallahi Muhammad if you do shirk. هَا لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ That's the جواب الشرط. أي لَيَبْطُلَنَّ It will be nullified and destroyed. What? جَمِيعَ All of your amal that you came with. As Allah mentioned in Surah Al-An'am, وَلَوْ أَشْرَكُوا لَحَبِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ After Allah mentioned 18 prophets, Allah mentioned that He will nullify all of their acts of obedience if they come with shirk. The same with you, Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then look what Allah said, which is a jumla ma'atufa. وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ This is a jumla ma'atufa ala jawab al-qasami that was mentioned, which is لَيَحَبَطَنَّ يعني وَلَتَكُونَ And you're going to be what? وَلَتَكُونَ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ غَايَةَ الْخُسْرَانِ You're going to be from those who are destroyed and lost in a severe way. And we say, brothers, again, وَحَاشَهُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ مِنَ الشِّرْكِ وَاللَّهِ النَّبِي مُحَمَّدِ is not going to do shirk, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah then says, بَلِ اللَّهِ بَلْ here is what? It's called لِلْإِضْرَابِ الْإِنْتِقَالِي. Allah is saying to the Prophet, اعبدوا الله تعالى وحده worship Allah تعالى alone وأخلص له وحده and single him سبحانه وتعالى in worship لا شريك له he has no partners أنت ومن اتبعك you and Muhammad and everyone who follows you وكن من الشاكرين and be a person who has شكر بقلبك in your heart ولسانك and on your tongue وبجوارحك and on your limbs be a person who shows gratitude to Allah تبارك وتعالى لما أنعم عليك يا محمد Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Allah has bestowed upon you, Muhammad, min al-nubuwati wa al-risala, Allah gave you prophecy, Allah gave you message, يعني made you a messenger. And this is the greatest thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give a person. As for the believers, Allah made you mu'minin. Allah gave you iman. Wa kun min al-shakirin, be a person who shows shukr. ولذلك عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, she mentions, كان صلى الله عليه وسلم يصلي حتى تفطرت قدمه he used to pray عليه الصلاة والسلام and he prayed until his legs swollen عليه الصلاة والسلام فقيل له لما تفعل ذلك why are you doing this to yourself وقد غفر لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر all of your sins have been forgiven for you Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم why are you doing this to yourself he said أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا am I not going to be a slave who shows gratitude to his Lord سبحانه وتعالى الإمام البخاري narrated this hadith in his Sahih and so did Al-Imam Muslim and Al-Nasa'i fi Qiyam al-Layl he narrated in his and also Tirmidhi in his Jami' يعني Nasa'i in his Mujtaba Qiyam al-Layl Tirmidhi narrated it in the chapter of Kitab al-Salah Ibn Majah in Iqamat al-Salah he narrated it min hadithi al-Mughira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu afala akuna abd al-shakura am I not going to be a slave who shows gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Then Allah says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبَضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Allah says, سبحانه وتعالى, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ They have not honored, يعني أي ما عظموه حق تعظيمه. They haven't honored Allah the way He deserves to be honored, سبحانه وتعالى. حين عبدوا معه غيره. When they worshipped other things besides Allah. Wallahi, they haven't honored him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they said Allah has a child, wallahi, they didn't honor him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they associated partners with Allah, wallahi, they didn't honor him. When they said Allah doesn't exist, wallahi, they didn't honor him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ And the day of judgment, wallahi, they're going to recognize this, the day of judgment, and they're going to regret it. تَاللَّهِ إِن كُنَّا لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ By Allah, we were upon clear-cut misguidance. We were upon plain error. That's what they're going to say. إِذْ نُسَوِّيكُمْ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ When we used to make you all equal to Allah. Wallahi, we were upon state of loss. We were upon clear error. That's what they're going to say. Ali ibn Abi Talha, he narrated from Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, may Allah be pleased with Abdullah ibn Abbas and his father. Abdullah ibn Abbas, and he said, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ He said, هُمُ الْكُفَّارِ These are the disbelievers. الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِقُدْرَةِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ They didn't believe يعني the ability of Allah over them. فَمَنْ آمَنَ Anyone who believes أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ Allah has the ability over everything. فَقَدْ قَدَرَ اللَّهَ This person has honored Allah حَقَّ قَدْرِي the way he deserved to be honored. وَمَنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِذَلِكَ And anyone who doesn't believe in that, فَلَمْ يُقَدِّرِ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِي That person hasn't honored Allah the way he deserved to be honored. وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ The whole entire world, okay? all of it are going to be in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's qabda. And the word qabda, it means ma yaqbidu bil yad. In the Arabic language is when you grab something with your fist. Okay, as the sha'ir said, وَمَنْ يَأْمَنِ الدُّنْيَا يَكُنْ مِثْلَ قَابِضٍ ha, عَلَى الْمَاءِ خَانَتْهُ فُرُوجُ الْأَصَابِعِ وَمَنْ يَأْمَنِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَنْ يَأْمَنِ الدُّنْيَا يَكُنْ مِثْلَ قَابِضِ عَلَى الْمَاءِ خَانَتْهُ فُرُوجُ الْأَصَابِعِ. يعني the earth, the entire dunya is all going to be in whose hand? Allah تبارك وتعالى. يعني والأراضين جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will grab it with his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالسَّمَوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتُ. And the sky, Allah will roll it up, subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني, he will roll it up together, subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Anbiya, يَوْمَ نَطْوِي السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُهُ وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا. Allah says, the day Allah rolls the whole entire sama, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he's going to do وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّةٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. يعني بِيَمِينِهِ means بِيَدِهِ الْيُمْنَى. Allah تبارك وتعالى both of his hands وَكِلْتَ يَدَيْهِ يَمِينٌ. Allah both of his hands is right, as the hadith in Sahih Muslim mentions, and an Imam al-Nasa'i narrated it من حديث عبد الله بن عمر بن العاص رضي الله تعالى عنهما. And there's a hadith which an Imam al-Bukhari narrated, and also an Imam Muslim, and also Ibn Majah. Ibn Majah mentions it in his Muqaddimah, that in Hadith Abi Hurairah, he says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يَقْبِضُ اللَّهُ الْأَرْضَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah will grab the earth the day of judgment. وَيَطْوِ السَّمَاءَ بِيَمِينِهِ, and he's going to roll the sama with his right. ثُمَّ يَقُولُ, and then Allah will say, أَنَا الْمَلِكُ, I am your sovereign. أَيْنَ مُلُوكُ الْأَرْضِ, where are the kings of the earth? Where are they gone? Also, يعني الإمام مسلم, بخاري didn't narrate it, and it's from the hadith which Muslim is alone in, but from Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, يطوي الله عز وجل, Allah is going to roll السماوات the heavens يوم القيامة the day of judgment. ثم يأخذهن, and Allah will grab it بيده اليمنى, he's going to grab it with his right hand. ثم يقول, Allah will then say, أنا الملك أين الجبارون, I am the sovereign. I am the king. Where are the jabbarun, the tyrants? Aina al-mutakabbirun, where are those who used to be arrogant and full of themselves? Thumma yatwi al-aradina bishimalihi, and then he will roll up the earth with his left. Thumma yaqulu, he will then say, ana al-malik, aina al-jabbarun, aina al-mutakabbirun. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned, ja'a habrun min ahbari ila rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. A Habr, which is a Jewish rabbi, came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال, he said, Ya Muhammad, إِنَّا نَجِدُ, we find, أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, يعني in our scripture, we find, إِنَّا نَجِدُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ يَجْعَلُ السَّمَاوَاتِ عَلَى إِصْبَعٍ, that Allah is going to place the samawat on one finger. وَالْأَرَضِينَ عَلَى إِصْبَعٍ, and that He's going to place the earth on one finger. وَالشَّجَرِ عَلَى إِصْبَعٍ, and the trees on one finger. وَالْمَاءَ وَالثَّرَى عَلَى إِصْبَعٍ, the sky and the water on one finger. وَسَائِلَ الْخَلَائِقِ عَلَى إِصْبَعٍ, and all the other creation on a finger. فَيَقُولُ, he will say, أَنَا الْمَلِكُ, I am the king. فَضَحِكَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Prophet, he laughed, حَتَّى بَدَتْ نَوَاجِدُهُ, until his molar teeth could be seen. تَصْدِيقًا لِقَوْلِ الْحَبْرِ, and he laughed in agreement to what that Jewish rabbi was saying, and he believed in him. And then look what the Prophet recited. He recited the ayah, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Then Allah تبارك وتعالى, he concluded the ayah by saying, سُبْحَانَهُ أَيْ تَنَزَّهَ وَتَقَدَّسَ. Allah تبارك وتعالى, he is free from, exalted, سُبْحَانَهُ وتعالى, وَتَعَالَى وَتَعَظَمَ, he is glorified and high, عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ, the ma in عَمَّا, that ma is mawsoolah, أي عن الذي يشركون به من الأصنام والأنداد وعن كل عيب ونقص. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He is high and He is exalted and He is greater. And it's a mawsoola, I said it's connective. Then what? All of the idols and the things which they what? Associate partners with Allah تبارك وتعالى. And Allah is also higher from all of the deficiencies that they attribute to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to conclude there inshallah ta'ala. anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdi ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.